Last jackrabbit I ever saw near Elgin, Texas, sometime in 1981, was hauling ass like a drag racer through the scrub, not touching any of it. I didn't even throw my gun up for a farewell salute like one time I would have. Back when we were kids growing up, there were millions of jackrabbits. They stood by desert highways like dumb sentinels posted every 100 yards, ground down to dish rags, those that didn't make the dash across. And we're not talking Peter Cottontail, the bunny from the briar patch here. We're talking long legs, big muley ears, jump 20 feet just like a deer. One night on the grass runway at Fort Clark near Brackettville, we shot so many jackrabbits we had half a pickup truck full. Nobody cared about the rabbits, but they told us not to leave the dead ones on the runway lest an airplane's tire get punctured. What a joke. As if something like that could actually happen, as if someday there would be no more jackrabbits. But we picked up all the dead ones and drove to a friend's house where we scattered them all over the yard, as a joke, of course. Because nobody ate jackrabbits, not white people. And without really thinking about it, I considered myself a white boy then. Well, there were jackrabbits outside Houston and down by Corpus Christi and New Mexico and everywhere you went out west. Riding at night, twin streams of headlight probing the darkness, faraway glow of towns and stars, and here and there, frozen by a mesquite or prickly pear, look, another one over there. On postcards, see giant jackrabbits with cowboys astride. See them stuffed with horns and planted behind many a bar to fool the gullible. Wow, that's a jackalope, har har. They're still around, those postcards, those jackalopes. But I've been from Austin to Jackson Hole, from Turkey to Terlingua, and they got postcards, they got tourist art and tacky ashtrays, but the jackrabbits are gone. And that's no joke, son. And you can blame it on chemicals and modern agriculture. Blame it on coyotes. Blame it on extraterrestrials, on ex-presidents of the United States and secret government experiments gone awry. Blame it on the loss of innocence and overwhelming sorrow without name. Blame it on high-balling 18-wheelers on long-ago Texas nights, or teenage boys with 22 rifles. Yeah, blame it on us, we did it. The last jackrabbit I ever saw near Elgin, Texas, sometime 1981, was hauling ass like a drag racer through the scrub and not touching any of it.